If you think clean code is hard, I'm gonna show you in this video that it's not as hard as it looks. Welcome to Le Coding! I'm Letícia Baleiro and today we're gonna talk about rules for names to have a clean code. If you don't know what I'm talking about, I strongly recommend you see the first video of this series where I explain what clean code is and why it's so important. All the links will be in the description. So let's go to the rules! The first rule for making clean code is that names matter. And to begin, you need to choose meaningful names. Pick your functions and variable names carefully. The name should reveal what the function does and what the variable represents. If you use this method, for example, what does this name tell you? Almost nothing. It's saving something. We don't know what or where. But if that function saves a new customer into the database, it should look more like this. Don't be afraid to make it a long name. It's really important that the name tells us what that function does. And this brings us to the next topic, the length of a name. Uncle Bob says the length of a variable name should be proportional to its scope. If you need to make a for loop where the index doesn't mean anything outside that scope, one letter is fine. For example, to sum all the grades in a list using a for loop, there is only one line for the scope, then the letter I can be enough. But if you have a variable that has a bigger scope and is going to be used in many places of your application, then its name should be very large, explaining what it is. For functions and classes, it's the opposite. The name should be inversely proportional to its scope. Which means for larger scopes, a function or class name should be shorter because it's going to be called many times and it should be as abstract as possible. For example, if you have a function that gets the user information from the API and your application uses it in many places, it could be a short name called getUser. But if you have another function that changes the color from the user's avatar, it should be called update user avatar color, a much bigger name that tells us the specific thing that function does in a much smaller scope. If you choose naming a variable like this, you'll never be able to find it in a quick search on your editor. But let's say this variable holds the Eiffel Tower high. We could rename it using a better name that is much easier to find when we search. Avoid negative names. Negative names makes it harder to read. In this example, if the cart's not full, it will skip the if condition and will go to the else block. In this other example, if the cart is full, it's because it's not empty, then it will go to the else block. Do you see that we need to go deeper to understand something that could be more simple? The same applies to the negative ifs because they are more complicated to understand than the positive ones. Here's a negative condition example. And here is the positive condition. See? It's easier to understand the positive statement. You have to think less. Don't make variables shorter by using prefixes. In the future, you're gonna forget what that variable means. For example, you shouldn't do this. But you should do these instead. Choose names that you can pronounce. In the same example, DateDMY can become DateDMY, and so on. It's not a name we can pronounce, then it's harder to read. But for date, day, month, year format, our brain makes less effort to read because it has words that make it easier to pronounce. Be careful with optical allusions. See these examples. Do you see that it's easy to confuse them? It's because they are very similar and their only difference is in the middle of the name. One possible solution is to put a different word in front of the name. This way, it's easier to see the difference between them. Make meaningful distinction between names. Check out these examples. Can you tell me the difference between those classes? Neither can I. It's because they say the same thing. All the classes have product information. If they do the same thing, then we should only have one class. If they do different things, then they should have names that show us the difference between them. In the next video, we are gonna be talking about a polemic topic, comments. So make sure to subscribe to the channel so you won't miss the next videos. And if you are enjoying this series, don't forget to hit the like button.